Good day. I wanted to take this opportunity during this blessed time as we're getting close to the month of Ramadan, the fasting month of Muslims, and talk a little bit about the relationship between kidney disease and fasting for the month of Ramadan. I am Dr. Rifai, the virtual nephrologist, and this, the main focus is going to be on who is allowed or giving the permission to break their fast. Now, in the Quran and the obligatory pillar of Islam, which is fasting month of Ramadan, there are two main entities that I wanted to separate. The first entity is a transient illness or traveling. So in the Quran, so whoever is ill or traveling, they are allowed to not fast and fast in another time as a payoff for that breaking the fast. So it's a transient illness, it's a reversible illness, and this is not the purpose of this video, as this requires more of the religious scholars to talk to you about the details of the travel, how far, how long, when, and how, same with the illness. What I'm going to talk about is for the people who cannot tolerate fasting because a chronic illness or a condition that will compromise their health if they perform the traditional fasting of the month of Ramadan. So there are five conditions that I'm going to be talking about for the fasting of the month of Ramadan that those patients, I call them patients, because these are people who have a chronic illness that can negatively impact their ability to stay healthy loosely if they fast the month of Ramadan. The first condition is the patients who are on hemodialysis or peritoneal dialysis. Without a doubt, those patients, if they fast, they seriously will put their lives at risk. And I don't want to encourage the question that on my off days, non-dialysis days, I should fast, even though on those off days, their health is extremely fragile. Fasting, the traditional Islamic fasting, will compromise their health. The other group of patients who have a kidney transplant, which is the gift of life. Those patients' gift of life or the kidney transplant is dependent completely on timely taking their immunosuppressive medications that they take exactly twice a day, 12 and 12, 5 and 5, 6 and 6. And for just to fast, it may compromise their ability to take those medicines on time and would put that transplanted patient at risk. Patients who have type 1 diabetes that they take 5 or 6 different insulin injections a day, they take their medicines and they're dependent on eating the same amount of carbohydrates in the same amount of time, 4 or 5 times a day, and take injections 4 or 5 times a day. Fasting would put them at extreme risk, diabetic ketoacidosis, hypoglycemia, and so forth. There is now two unique group of patients that in a way they're gray regarding the ability or inability to fast, but patients who have chronic kidney disease, stage 4 and 5, those patients are definitely at risk of having dehydration or complications if they don't take their medicine because they're fasting. Stage 3, 2, and 1, those patients, I would encourage you to ask your doctors to ask if it is safe to fast or not. And you would know yourself if you take one medicine once a day for CKD2, or if you take 10 medicines per day because you have CKD2, and that is left up to you and your doctor. Patients who have congestive heart failure, where it is essential for them to take medicines that will protect the heart and also make him live longer, as well as protect from fluid retention, it is advisable not to fast. Last but not least, patients with kidney stones, they are dependent on drinking a lot of fluids. You would know, consult your righteous nephrologist, because they will know your case and will give you a clear advice whether it is safe to fast and put yourself at a dehydration risk, or if it's not safe to fast where we have to drink a lot of fluids every day. I hope with this I made it very clear that the conditions where you cannot tolerate fasting because of a chronic illness, you should seriously consider not fasting. Because the purpose of fasting is not to put yourself at risk and to challenge yourself getting close to complications, but the purpose of fasting is to purify yourself. These are chronic illnesses like chronic kidney disease, whether you're on dialysis, kidney transplant, heart failure, type 1 diabetes, or if you have kidney stones. With this, I am Dr. Rifai, the virtual nephrologist. I hope I made it clear for you to understand your illness and whether fasting the month of Ramadan is advisable or not. Assalamu alaikum, Ramadan Mubarak.